In the early hours of October 7, 1998, in Laramie, Wyoming, a senseless act of hate led to the death of a young man with a promising future. His death affected the nation and the world.
Police say Shepherd was lured from this Laramie night spot. He was later robbed, beaten, and left for dead, tied to this fence post outside of town.
The first reports of Matt's attack started showing up Thursday night on some of the Denver stations, and it was reported as a gay bashing or a possible hate crime.
When we saw him, it was like he didn't even look like Matt. He had stitches all over his face, and it was swollen, and bandages all over his head, and
he was basically begging. He was asking them to stop hitting him, telling them that they were hurting him, not to hurt him anymore.
We didn't want him to feel the trauma of the whole thing, so we played his favorite music. We sprayed his cologne around the room.
Early this morning, freshman Matthew Shepherd died from injuries he received in a vicious beating.
Authorities charged two men, Aaron McKinney and Russell Henderson, with Shepherd's murder.
Dennis said, just leave me in a room with them alone for 10 minutes and I'll take care of the whole thing. Of course, we knew we couldn't do that.
The only place that he didn't have any blood on him on his face was what appeared to be where he'd been crying down his face.
None of it made any sense to us. The degree of violence was just, it was horrific. Later, we came to understand that when it's a hate crime, this is a definite signal of a hate crime, that level of violence.
Today, on the University of Wyoming campus, there were armbands and mourning for a student whose death has focused national attention on hate and violence.
I am so pissed off.
President Clinton is urging Congress to expand a federal hate crimes law following the beating death of a gay student in Wyoming. Matthew Shepherd died at a Colorado hospital yesterday after he was brutally attacked last week. Cynthia Bowers reports.
We shall overcome.
Friends and supporters of Matthew Shepherd gathered at sunset last night.
I knew deep down immediately that this was going to be a hugely important story for our community, and that how the media covered this was going to have a huge impact on people's perceptions of the gay and lesbian community.
When the media hit Laramie, again, I think it was an opportunity for Laramie to step up, show the pride in that community, to show that we don't condone any kind of activity like that.
I remember greeting people as they came in. Some we knew and some we didn't. I remember the beautiful service, the beautiful music. And Matt had been cremated, and his urn was in a beautiful oak box in front of the altar. And it had a ceramic mountain scene on it, and everybody would touch it when they went by.
McKinney will be the first to stand trial. Russell Henderson pleaded guilty and was sentenced to two consecutive life terms earlier this year.
Aaron McKinney sentenced to two life sentences. One of those life sentences is for his conviction for felony murder and second degree murder.
More than a year ago, our son Matthew was murdered because he was gay. He was a victim of a brutal crime motivated by hatred. The outcome of this trial will never bring Matthew back to us. But we believe that justice was served today.
I think Matthew Shepherd's death was one of those unique events in American history that galvanized most hearts beyond bias.
Even when he was a toddler, he would come sit on your lap and say, what's the matter with you? Did something happen to you today? Did you have a bad day? He had a terrible temper. And when things didn't go right, he could throw a fit royal and argue that the sky was yellow when you knew it was blue. And he was like that through his whole life. He enjoyed the debate very much.
The thing I remember most about Matt was his incredible smile. His entire body would smile and his eyes would light up and sparkle. It was just kind of an infectious smile that made your day better.
Matt was everybody's friend. He was just the kindest person, someone you could trust, someone you could go to. I mean, he was just a very caring person. He was involved in the arts and theater. He's kind of larger than life. He's very over the top in everything that he does.
Our father's brought forth.
Matt's dreams for his college education included political science and languages. He was very good at languages. He was fluent in German, Italian, somewhat French, knew some Arabic and Japanese.
Matt always talked about wanting to make a difference in the world. I think we all want to do that somehow.
It would have been, I'm sure, a real temptation to say, please leave me alone. I have my grief. And instead, they used it to help others.
Going from the absolute pit of devastation and then taking all that energy and somehow managing to use it to create this force of goodness and love in the way that she does.
She is such a special woman and so filled with love, which is so extraordinary for someone to have gone through something like this.
When it comes to hate crimes, and it comes to the way that people understand gay people, it's amazing how much has happened since Matthew died. And it's amazing how much Judy has had a part of that.
I had this hunch that she was on the beginning of a very new journey in her life that was going to take her somewhere that was going to make a real difference.
I think the thing you got to know about Judy is that behind that placid exterior beats the heart of a tiger.
Since Matt died, we have become acutely aware of the forces at work in this country that seek to do harm to the gay community. We will stand with you in this struggle to ensure equality, dignity, and respect for every gay American, every American.
I think the thing that I love so much about Dennis Shepherd is that he's one of the few dads that will get up and speak really strongly about loving and accepting unconditionally his gay son.
My biggest hope is that other fathers will stand up and say, I have a son or I have a daughter that I am proud of, that I love dearly, who happens to be gay. Thank you very much.
To honor Matthew's dreams, beliefs, and aspirations to make a difference in the world, Dennis and Judy Shepherd created the Matthew Shepherd Foundation. The foundation seeks to replace hate with understanding, compassion, and acceptance through its educational outreach and advocacy programs. The foundation's Erase Hate Project is the heart of the organization's work and mission. As part of this goal, Judy has spoken to over 1 million people at colleges, corporations, and religious institutions throughout the country and the world about the need to make schools and communities more accepting of everyone. Judy and Dennis continue to take their message to erase hate to the airwaves through public service announcements and television interviews.
We had a meeting and we just knew that if we went down that road of anger and hate that we'd be victims too. And I wasn't going to give anybody that kind of power.
The Matthew Shepherd Foundation has been at the forefront of the effort for congressional passage of the federal hate crimes legislation known as the Matthew Shepherd Act.
If we can find the strength and courage to stand up and speak out against hate crimes, then Congress ought to have the same strength and courage.
Judy and the Foundation's advocacy were instrumental in the recent historic passage of the Matthew Shepherd Act in both the United States House of Representatives and Senate.
This is a very simply stated, as Mrs. Shepherd has pointed out, that we do not want to have second-class citizens in the United States of America.
This law, symbolic as it is, can change hearts and minds and can be real substance.
It is stories, true human stories, that drive change. And Matthew Shepard's is one of the most profound of all.
Matthew's story is told in Small Bear, Big Dreams, an educational program for pre-K to high school students that the foundation provides free to schools and parents to help them teach compassion, respect, and acceptance.
The foundation's Youth First Project works to ensure that GLBTQ and allied youth have a significant voice and resources in society.
Dennis and I and Logan knew that we wanted this to be an organization that focused on young people, because they seem to be the ones really, really struggling.
One way that the project supports GLBTQ youth is through MatthewsPlace.com. This comprehensive online village is a safe place full of critical resources and information. A place where GLBTQ youth can see themselves reflected in our society, feel affirmation, and gain insights to help them lead healthy, productive, hate-free lives. Through its homeless and disenfranchised youth program, the foundation is committed to ensuring that GLBTQ youth are safe, valued, and respected. GLBTQ youth are being driven to the streets at an unacceptable rate. This program seeks to raise public awareness about the reality facing these young people and engage individuals and direct service providers to help GLBTQ youth build healthy and successful lives.
The Foundation's Equality Project seeks to ensure gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender equality by focusing on getting members of the GLBT and allied community to vote with initiatives like its aggressive 2006 Get Out the Vote campaign, and through its civil rights program that supports legislation that impacts the GLBT community.
You don't have to like us, you don't have to believe in it, you just have to respect that under the Constitution, and when it comes to civil rights and benefits, we are all equal under the law, or we live in a different kind of country than the one we think we do.
When you have a foundation like the Matthew Shepard Foundation, you have a leader like Judy and a leader like Dennis, and you have the opportunity to say, we're going to keep putting the spotlight on this until everybody pays attention. We will call this what it is, and it is hate, pure and simple.
My long-term goal is that it isn't needed anymore, that the gay community is no longer separated from everybody else as the gay community, where everything is equal, where it's a totally accepting society on every avenue.
Someday, the fight to erase hate will be a memory. Until then, the Matthew Shepard Foundation will help lead the way.